Okay, guys, we're back, and I'm going to work on doing this background a little bit here. And before I finish up this further, I want to make sure that I have all of the background done. So as I'm doing the finishing touches, the coloring is correct. And this is really kind of blended into the background, but I needed to put the darks in before I can bring in the lights. And so I just need to obviously lighten up the background here to really make this part stand out the way I need to. I am leaving brush strokes. That's a little bit of the impressionist, I have done it over here too. So before I finish this guy up and finish this guy up, because this is not done still, but in order to do the background simultaneously, I had to have both components built up. So that's where we are at with that. Let's see if I can get this to stay up here at all. Okay, a quick note about what I'm doing here. Now, I don't have a true red, but as we know, I can get this beautiful orangey red off of the magenta. So again, these are all the heavy body paints because I really want them to cover. This is a cobalt teal here. Burnt umber is right there. I need some good ground color. Burnt umber, raw sienna. Cadmium yellow light. Quinacridone magenta. Ultramarine blue. Phthalo blue. Now, they may look fairly similar, but they do much different things on the canvas. Yellow ochre. Is this guy. Again, a great ground color, a very earthy color. I did put in this gold. This is not an expensive paint. This is a much less, but so this is academic level 1, and all of these are basically level 3. Not that there's anything wrong with it, just know that it has a different quality to the paint. These are going to be very smooth. Actually, these are generally very smooth also. I always use titanium white. The reason for titanium white is it is the least transparent. This is what they always had us use in art school, and I've used it ever since. Red oxide, again, is similar to burnt sienna, and both are very good. And then a cadmium yellow deep hue, and sap green. So this is a series 1 also, so this might not be the higher quality paint. I did go through and really try to get a set of good quality paints a few years ago. But then I still didn't paint because I was too busy riding across the country. So, all right. This side is coming along well, but, I figured out how to do the train tracks here. I was having a little bit of difficulties with that here. And it's not that I don't really feel like I need to go in and put in these train tracks, but it might actually help me if I did. So, can you use gesso for white? Yes. So, dirty water. You see how that water is dirty and that automatically changed the color of my white? I won't be able to get anything super bright white with dirty water. Is that okay at this point in time? Right now, it's okay. It might not be later. Okay, so you see how this blue is a very purpley blue. I don't think that's the one we want to use. That is ultramarine. This is the phthalo. See the difference? Once you start adding the white to it, you can really tell the difference between the phthalo and the ultramarine. Hold on.
Ozzy! Us!
No barks.